between 16th and 24th of April 2016, a joint team of IDRC and microwave scientists, University of Manitoba, Canada, University of Saskatchewan, Canada, Uniosu, OAU, and University of Paracu, Benin Republic, and NGOs visited some farm sites in Nigeria and Benin Republic. The purposes of the field visit were to fulfill the tenets of value for money, ethical standards, meet and interact with the benefiting farmers, and ascertain the scientific development delivery of the project. The visit provided first-hand opportunity to assess the state of project implementation and aided useful suggestions on the path to follow during the remaining project period. The visit also allowed the IDRC and the project teams to meet the officers of the partner institutions to discuss the project and the level of adherence to project schedules and timelines. The field visit also created the opportunity for a brief project meeting in Nigeria and Benin with discussions led by Dr. Innocent Butari. These are the list of some of the people on the team. Dr. Innocent Butari, IDRC Program Officer. Professor Clement Adeboye, Regional Project Coordinator, Microveg. Professor Duro Oyedele, Principal Investigator, OAU. Professor Derek Peake, Principal Investigator, University of Saskatchewan, Canada. Professor David Nacha, Co-Investigator, University of Saskatchewan, Canada. Dr. Irenikashe Akonipe, Principal Investigator, University of Paracu, Benin. Professor Rotimi Aluko, Principal Investigator, University of Manitoba, Canada. We're going to take you through the journey from Lagos to the Republic of Benin. Happy viewing.
Today we are welcoming you to our zone to see what you have been doing for us. You have done a lot because your representative, we have done a lot for the farmers here in the Ajo zone. They have helped us a lot, not monetarily, but with equipment, pumping machine, seedling, and other things. Training is not left behind. They have been trying for us and they still promise of trying more, giving us more. As you people are giving them to we farmers, vegetable farmers, most especially in Ajo State, in Ajo Zone, we have been getting very good help from them. The professor and other members. We want you to continue to help us. Since you can think, you don't think of yourself alone. You don't think of your family alone. You
Don't think of your local government alone. Don't think of your state alone. Don't think of your country alone. You can only you think of other countries, and you are doing this to us. God will help you.
Amen.
God will help you.
Amen.
And we too, we as a dozen, will use this opportunity given to us to gear up other zones, to gear up Lagos State, to gear up Nigeria, and to gear up other countries by imitating you to help them as you are helping us. God will be with you.
Great farmers!
Great nation!
No farmer!
No nation!
And no food!
No nation!
I want to thank you most sincerely for coming. As I told you, or as I've been telling you over and over, that one day, people who fund us, who provide money for us, that they will come here. And not just here, they will come to this place and also go to Benin Republic. I don't tell you before, say our project reach Nigeria and reach Benin Republic.
The main objective of my visit is to see what you are doing with these people in the green shirts. If what the writing in the reports is what I will see on the ground. So I'm really happy to be with you. I read good things in the reports, but today I want to see with you in the field. I would like to. I will ask some questions, especially on about how you farmers you interact with researchers and with other stakeholders working with vegetables. I mean buyers, transporters, and others. Thank you very much.
Hello. Sir, these are, to make it confirm, these are the high trees that we do. Mm-hmm. On the training, transport, laser, quantity, hire, marketers, finance, all these people, we invite them to attend, to give us the idea, to interact with them, exporters and others.
So, do you have problems with seeds?
Yes.
How you get seeds?
We get
improved seed.
We get our seed from open market, but when they started coming here, the pro they started giving us seedlings. They give us dried one, we nurse it, we transplant. Ugu seed, they bring it for us. So it reduced the one we have been buying from open market. Since they started with us, they have been supplying us with seedlings.
They have been here and we appreciate what they have been telling us and what they have brought to us. They have given us some things. And we appreciate it. We receive some seed and we receive a pumping machine. And they promise that they will come to train us. Sir.
And your production?
Yes, and the production is increasing from the seed. And even the pumping machine helps us. It helps us. No farmer.
No food.
No food.
No nation.
I am Mrs. Onoha Bushman. I'm a member, a representative of Lagos State in Ojozun, and I'm also farming in Ojozun. My farm is in Lasu campus. Our Esther has come to see our farm. We in Lasu, we plant predominantly ugu vegetable. So she came there, she saw ugu too. In addition to what she has said, we are the women, we have the marketers. The problem she has said concerning marketing, is the problem we are facing. And that's why we are looking forward for macroveg to source export market for us. Most of our farmers are farmers for the exporters, and they take our vegetable for a peanut and they make their dollars out of it, and we make nothing. So we are looking forward that is one of the challenges. We'll expect the microveg to assist us so that we will be exporting our vegetable direct. Even the ADA, we have been having a stakeholders meeting on exportation of non-oil produce, especially on vegetables. And there's a department for it from the Lagos State Government. They have been trying their best to help us to get through. And I know that through the help of microveg, it will be easier and for us.
A lot of seeds. Here you have close to a million here.
1 hectare or more?
It plants more than 1 hectare.
1 hectare.
Close to 1 hectare. If you mix it out, yes.
Okay. And this is the chick, this dressing we just introduced.
These are the treatments. Yes. To safeguard the seeds. It has really helped them here.
Okay.
Yes.
Good.
Oh, okay.
Oh, please, let me take the... See the female.
Okay.
You see the difference.
Yeah.
The female is producing the pop.
You see the pro. You see the. See it. See a bigger one.
Yeah. The other one. Mm-hmm.
So you see it.
Yeah.
This is the female.
Okay.
And this is the male flower.
Yeah.
Okay.
And when so, the female always that one is not.
Let me tell you another thing. This plant
Look at the male plant. What can you see about it? It's very tiny.
Tiny, yeah. Yeah.
See the female, yeah. Very robust.
Strong, yes.
Look at the greenness of the leaf.
Yeah, yeah.
The female is greener and glossier, okay, than the male.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Mm-hmm.
So, but you know one problem. When they start growing, you cannot identify the two.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
It is until they flower like this.
Same. Okay.
And maybe when they are growing and you are able to see the difference in the physiology, mm-hmm, the anatomy. You see this one, see the stem. Thicker.
Yeah, the female is very thicker. Mm-hmm.
You see it?
Yeah.
See this man? See this man?
This man is taunted.
I'm Derek Peake. I'm a professor at the University of Saskatchewan working on the microveg project. And today we've seen three different farmer sites where they're growing vegetables and then talk to communities where the project is making a difference. And it's really, really impressive to see on the ground all of the things that are written in the reports that it's, you know, we talk about scaling up, but it's not just numbers of people. It's not just numbers on a paper. It's really people that are, lives are being improved. So I think that's the main thing I've taken away from my visit today.
Yeah. Are you impressed with what you've seen so far?
Yeah, absolutely.
Hi, I'm David Natcher. I'm a professor at the University of Saskatchewan in Canada. It's a real privilege to be in Nigeria on this trip, and seeing how small-scale farmers are making a living in agriculture, and it's a real pleasure to be here.
Are you impressed with what you've seen so far?
I am. I think the knowledge of the local farmers and the way they've been able to collaborate with researchers, I think there's some really unique partnerships been established here.
Thank you for your time.
You bet. Yeah.
The first day he came here, he dazed my farmers. Microfetch dazed my farmers. Because they never came at that time to just meet us alone. The first day they are coming in, they came with inputs, water pumps, name it, vegetable seeds of different varieties. And ever since, we have improved on what we are doing, thereby supporting the effort of BATN that has already been assisting us. So last week we did the flag off of this project. The flag off of this project was done last week. The handing over of the project by BATN was done last week. So all the farmers here that are gathered here were happy that day. Both the participating farmer under this project and those that are not under this project.
So we are collaborating to assist farmers at this level of Ajara to better their lots in the area of the vegetable production. And as Alhaji said, I must give credit to Alhaji for being unrelenting. He mounted a lot of pressure on me to bring me here and to ensure that we do what we know best to do to make things better for the farmers. I won't say more than that.
Our colleagues who as food scientists have worked on, they have produced biscuits with ugu and ibagba, and they also produce shinshin and bread. Actually, I don't know how many of you are familiar with yale biscuit and that's sumal food. We already in discussion with them. We met our technical people and we are in discussion on how they can buy into it. And we have given them samples of the powder because we have to dry the products, powder it, and we've given them a sample so that they are also testing. Then we are also discussing with butterfield bread. So possibility of using part of this, if they can buy into it, then the market will be very huge. Then on on the soil, it may be very difficult to now say we want to carry soil and bring it here. By the time we calculate the cost, we find that even it will be much more expensive than the vegetable. But what we can do when we have a soil that is sandy is if you have a poultry nearby, if you mix it with poultry manure, then you'll be able to retain water.
You are welcome.
How are you?
I'm well.
Welcome to you.
Welcome, sir.
No, we don't need to wait for them.
Vegetable as usual group of Ibala, Road, Ilesha, Mr. Adesu, Olowe.
Yes.
Okay. Ajowa Vegetable as usual group, Mr. Abdusalam Friday.
Yes.
Okay. So, if you plant it and ask, nobody will accept it or let out the value. So, we do based on the main vegetable, the plant, maybe the vegetable. I think I want to show you the amount of
this you eat, leaves or fruit?
He taught us how to, you know, to apply things so that it will not affect the vegetables, and at the same time it will not affect all the consumers.
Mm-hmm.
You understand? Because, and then there is something I see in their method. Mm-hmm. And that is it. You see, our vegetable, the storage facility cannot be more than 1 or 2 days. Mm-hmm. But when they and when they taught us, I discovered that it is more than 4 to 5 days. So that is some of the difference I see in the two.
Yes, I
know
you
have.
I saw it.
Okay. So now you apply small quantities.
Yes, we apply small quantities.
Okay.
Can you see? So that is a good thing.
On the right.
Yes.
How?
It is the same? 100%.
No, 46%.
Only.
Because on the bag. It's a single fertilizer. Straight fertilizer. No, they put it in that bag.
So we plant together, and during harvest time, we are here to harvest it and take them to the market.
It is not to separate. We are always together.
We are, yes,
we work together.
We work together.
Even in training, you are trained together.
Yes, we used to train us.
Really?
My name is Otimi Alupo. I'm a professor at the University of Manitoba in Winnipeg, Canada. So I'm one of the principal researchers on this project, and my own perspective is value addition, basically to enhance processing of vegetables into products that are very healthy for human beings. And apart from the processing into products that are very healthy, we're also looking at processing the vegetables so that they have longer shelf life, so the farmers don't have to sell vegetables immediately because they have too much. They don't have to sell it at a very cheap price. All right, so when we process it for them, then they can actually store it for a long time, and they can sell it just as the demand comes. In that way, they can sell it at the price they want, not at the price the buyer wants. All right. My own perspective is the fact that we've made significant progress in producing a concentrate that we can actually incorporate into big products, actually, bread, biscuits, chin chin, for example. we can incorporate this concentrate that we have produced from the leaves, we can put them into these baked products, and that makes the bread healthier for the population. One of the benefits of putting such a product in, say, baked goods, is the fact that, especially for people who, for example, have diabetes, when you put this concentrate of the vegetables in the bread, the rate of digestion of the bread is lower. And so somebody who has diabetes, if they eat that bread, it's better than just eating plain white bread, because the rate at which the glucose goes into their blood is lower, and they can actually cope very well compared to just normal white bread. And apart from that, we know that some of the compounds in the leaves, which we call antioxidants, they actually are very helpful in reducing these diseases, especially things like, you know, hypertension, you know, stroke, even sometimes, you know, helping to improve memory. It is believed that some of those compounds can be used to reduce the rate of dementia, loss of memory. So we think, apart from just, you know, being able to increase market value of the vegetables, that the population will also benefit in health-wise by consuming these products.
Wow. Thank you so much.
Yeah. Thank you very much.
God bless you, sir.
Okay, thank you.
My name is Dr. Renikachi Akwenipe. I'm the principal investigator of the University of Paraku in the Republic of Benin. And we are here for the monitoring tour to see what our two partners of the University of OAU and Osun State University are doing on the ground concerning the objectives of our project. And we are happy to be going around and to be seeing that the project is doing its best, and the result that we are having are very exciting. And the farmers are very committed to what we are doing. We are promoting two main innovations, a package of agronomic technologies. And the other one is the two models of scaling up. So the partners, the universities in Nigeria here are doing a good job. And we expect that with this momentum, we will reach and even overpass our objectives. That is all that I can tell you.
Thank you so much for your time, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you. Yeah.
Be able to make the bed. The prof told us that we should make the 2 by 2 meters bed, and whenever we want to plant, we should use it. What want to learn about this program?
Okay. When we are doing the bed, digging it, and we plant the ugu, and ametan. Then, when we dig it finish, we remove the. With the stones, and we plant our ugu.
How did you plant the ugu? How come about the plantation?
Okay, we do the this thing.
Spotting.
The spotting, okay. Remove it, and we put the ugu inside. Seed. The seed. I put it in inside, and we use
the you mulch? How did
you
mulch it?
Put the grass.
How did you do your mulch?
So that
put the grass on it. When we
have you been doing?
The idea of working with schools, what is behind?
Champions. Building champions.
Getting them.
We have been
looking for a way of covering all those wounds. We have been telling those people who have sheep,
goats,
that usually, and goats, mm-hmm. that usually flock around this place.
Yeah.
And we told the Fulani herd men that drove their cows around this place yesterday, mm-hmm. and we warned them. We first of all told them gently, then later on I warned them. It was around 4 o'clock yesterday I was here at that time. Told them, and they oblique to what I told them, that they will not direct the cattle to disturb our crops.
Welcome, guests, and also the team members, of the microbe team, to Robert National University, Lefe, one of the host universities, hosting the project. We are expecting the Dean's representative to join us soon. So, just welcome our guests here. Yeah. And then, our guests have been around, the team has been around since Sunday evening. And we'll be going around our project sites at different locations. We just want to welcome them. And also here we have many of our students that have been sponsored. Because we know that this the project program is funded by about 5 universities and 5 institutions.
Most of them are working on soil science. It's the influence of the record. Why?
On that, the one on agribusiness. I also have a student, you introduce yourself, you'll be your partner. So,
it's been interesting being around in the last 4 days. We welcome all our colleagues who have traveled all the way from Canada to this part of the world. Perhaps I should do one more introduction of Innocent Kintari. He's our age long friend, long standing. He's the person who we say give the money or don't give the money. So, Innocent? He will give the money. That is the only person that can say so. We want to thank you for coming, Innocent. Roti, we are so glad that you are here. And perhaps I should give you a breakdown. Or you look down some events that are taking place. Though you've read the reports that we had baseline study, which was coordinated by Professor Anyawale and our colleagues from Sociology Department, I want to put it on record before all of you that they did exceedingly tremendous job. So, you remember we were talking about ODK? You remember? They designed it. That software makes data application, data analysis, data cleaning very, very easy. And that's why you have the baseline report as early as possible. Because we used to know that for IDRC project, baseline reports are submitted at the end of the 3rd year. And you ask the scientist, where is the report? They say it's in the computer. You want me to computer, print it out, they say it's inside the computer. But this time it's not inside the computer. You have the report. And I want to assure you that by September, when you will have the next report, that baseline report would have been fine-tuned to almost 99% perfection, including all those 2 issues you raised in the review report, inclusion of irrigation and some other things. We are trying to bring all those into it. Also, I want to thank our sociology team for the training of the students and other scientists in the use of some new statistical software. I attended 3 of such trainings here. I don't know much of statistics, but I always come here to familiarize with them and to show them that we identify with the project. So I want to thank them once again. The food science team has been very, very wonderful. I was discussing with you yesterday that we have huge information, very huge information on value addition, both done at the University of Manitoba and this university. By the time the next report, time comes and we put all this to you, you will not be able to ask questions.
Examination. 2 students in my class were from Nigeria, and they came
I said, have you ever been? And I said, no, this will be my first trip. And they said, it will be very warm. And they were right. but they also said the people are going to be very kind and generous. Yeah. And they were right as well.
We are putting vegetables into chicken, into cookies, into everything, into bread. If people buy brown bread, chocolate, why can't people buy green bread? So we want to find a way that we make people to eat vegetable without actually consuming the vegetable diet. And this is what you see. This work has been coordinated by our colleagues at the University of Manitoba and the Obafemi-Awolowo University, Department of Science and Technology. So all of us make input into this. In terms of funding to make sure the process is driven smoothly to arrive at all this. So our idea now is to transform this to industrial use.
Colleagues and graduate students, I want to appreciate the Vice Chancellor, also the team members for welcoming us to this gathering, and also want to appreciate you for the way you have been supporting the project. Because if one institution is lacking in support of the institution, the Fed will be felt even for the whole project. I want to appreciate the support offered by the university to state in support of the project. I also want to assure you that the objective that I set, we thank God that we are able to make it, but also we assure you that together, we to accomplish even more than set objectives and to make our power, because the objective is to get to improve the lot of rural women farmers so that economically we can, through the cultivation and processing of vegetables, we can improve their lot and make life better for them. That's the ultimate thing. And together, as we are moving in the right direction, is that we are happy with this. And once again, I want to appreciate the university, I want to appreciate my colleagues. Thank you very much.
Well, first of all, I want to thank the Busan State University and all of the other members of the team for all of the efforts and also for all of the hospitality that we've had in our trip so far. Being so far away in Canada, you see emails and you see reports and you see progress being made on paper, but it's hard to really understand until you get the opportunity to come and see it in person and experience it on the ground. And the amount of work and effort that's going into this project is really, really quite impressive to see in person. And then in addition to that, the opportunities to train PhD students and the students that are living and breathing this project while they get their degrees, thank you for that work, because I know it's very challenging. And I think that's all I want to say.
We have made the full decision with all the charges for our PhD students.
On behalf of the IDRC team, we are hereby presented with this check for full sponsorship of your PhD program.
In the Department of Agriculture Extension and Rural Sociology at the University of Ibadan. Our food tuition and all other charges related to our studies are included in this job.
Yeah, on behalf of the IDR, we are here to present them with this check for full sponsorship.
Elles nous sont chères que depuis là-bas, on a roulé 12 heures de temps, de 7 heures du matin à 19 heures le soir pour venir ici au Bénin, pour être à l'heure. Ce soir.
To gien. Be ba sanon ko za bulun ko ba no ba yirondi. Sey jo kan ko ba no ba yiro. Ye ye ro mi de ko wa kura yirumba. Tonun bonu mi. Benson.
Oye! Oye! Donc on va présenter ceux qui sont venus avec nous. Donc, on va présenter Dr. Innocent Boutaré, qui est le chargé du programme de CSDI, donc c'est le bailleur. Donc, tout ce que nous arrivons à venir faire ici, c'est lui qui dit, oui, allez-y, non, ça, vous ne pouvez pas, voici l'argent, ou bien, il n'y a pas l'argent.
So, on est beaucoup de temps, si vous tournez. Vous tournez. Oui, c'est un Dr. Boutaré. Oui, c'est un... Non. Oui, c'est un... Et où est projet un titi gros titi bien au bénébé bac à gouéné bien son son robe est tellement coco bien midi bien ou à mon
name is Innocent Boutaré. I'm based in Nairobi, IDRC office in Nairobi. I'm working in for agriculture and food security program, and I'm in charge of monitoring and the administration of this project. So I'm coming from Rwanda. I'm Rwandan, but working for IDRC since 17 years.
Satisfied so far with things you've seen since the since we started this talk?
Yes, I'm happy. I'm very happy because from what I saw, the project is in good hands, and I'm confident that it will reach its goals and objectives. Why I can say this? First, the interaction between scientists, farmers, NGOs, local decision makers is very good. So the quality of this interaction is very important for the success of the project. And with the new method of scaling up innovation, what we call innovation platforms, we try to put together all the stakeholders in a value chain together and to solve problems. So from what I saw, this is they are the scientists, farmers, and other stakeholders are doing well to identify challenges and to try to find together solutions. So I'm very confident.
Thank you very much. And from the responses of the farmers, you know, and you were able to interact with them, I know I've seen you on so many occasions discussing with them. So what can you say to their reactions, their comments? How do you respond?
From what I saw, they are doing well, but they still have challenges. The first one is seeds. How they can have seeds of good quality. And when I discussed with scientists, they told me they have good seeds, but the problem is quantities. So now for the year coming, they are trying to train farmers in seed production. And I think if researchers really make effort to train farmers in seed productions, not all farmers, because all of them, they can't do seed production. Seed production is requires skills. So, but some of them can invest in this activity, producing good quality seeds and sell them to others. And I think this is really the way to go. This is the first challenge. The second challenge was marketing, markets, access to markets. And really, from what I heard from them, this is a very big issue for them. And during the discussion with scientists, they informed me they are working on this issue by trying to find markets out of the local markets. Maybe, for example, in processing vegetables and interest people from the food industry to use vegetables for other things, for example, for bread, for and other food, processed food. So I think this is really an innovative way to solve the problem of market access.
Okay, lastly, what are the future plans? What do you have what do you have in view for the remaining years of this program?
Yeah. What we have in view is to reach a big number of farmers. So because, as I told you before, we used to finance small projects and scientists produce good scientific papers, but we don't change life of people. What we want now is to change life of people, and not just a village, but a large number of them. In these projects, for example, we are trying to reach, I think, more than 50,000 people directly, and more than 1 million indirectly. So we want, what we want is science for development and science for really impact on the ground. So now we are going to push scientists and farmers, of course, and other stakeholders, how to, what is the best way, what is, how we can reach this large number, because we don't know, till now, we don't know how to do to reach a large number of people.
Thank you very much. It's been a wonderful time talking to you today.
Thank you.
And we wish you another wonderful time as we go to Kutan from tomorrow to continue your trip.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thanks for watching.
Okay.